हेलो एवरीवन, हेलो। ओके, लेट्स बिगिन आवर क्लास। सिट अप स्ट्रेट, नाउ क्लोज योर आईज, हैंड्स ऑन योर नीज, स्पाइन स्ट्रेट।
Bluetooth mode. Connect.
Now we will start chanting 3 times om together. Take a deep breath in. Join your hands together in front of your heart center. Bend your head forward. Then open your eyes while blinking. Namaste to everyone. Okay, let's begin. So find yourself in the tabletop. Now press your hands on the floor. As you inhale, lift your head up, make an arch on your back. Exhale, roll your spine, drop your head down, hump on your back. Inhale, lift your head up, make an arch on your back. Exhale, drop your head down, hump on your back, push your hip forward. Inhale, make an arch on your back, lift your head up. Exhale again, drop your head down, hump on your back. One more time, take a deep breath in, lift your head up, and then hold there for 3, 2, and 1. Exhale, drop your head down, hump on your back, push your hip forward. Inhale, head up, make an arch on your back, and then hold for 3. Again, lift your head up, complete your inhalation. 2 and 1. Exhale, drop your head down, hump on the back. Now with the next inhalation, keep your spine straight into the neutral position. Extend your right hand forward, stretch your arm in front, stretch your right hand forward, and then exhale, drop your right outer edge of your palm on the floor, and then turn your head to the left side and then hold. 1. Extend your right hand forward. Extend your right hand forward. Drop your right palm on the floor and then stretch it out and look in front. So it's as same as like a puppy pose. In this, we are extending only one hand and then hold. Turn your head. Look up to the ceiling. 3, 2, and 1. Exhale, release back into the center, into the tabletop. Inhale, extend your left hand forward. Keep stretching out. Exhale, release your left palm on the floor and then turn your head to the right side and look up high. 1. two, and three. Exhale, release back into the tabletop. Inhale, one more time, extend your right hand forward. Drop your edge of the palm on the floor, and then reach up. You can make a cup of finger with your left hand. Look up high, keep stretching out. Hips should be right above your knees, and then hold for three, two, and one. Exhale, release back into the tabletop. Now with the next inhalation, extend your left hand forward. Exhale, release your left hand on the floor right there, and then twist your spine. Look up high. Just feel that nice extension will start to come out on your left underarmpit. Three, two, and one. Exhale, release back into the tabletop. Now turn your both palms out to the side, and then start to move side to side. One, two, three, keep moving, four, and five. Now bring yourself back to the center, turn your both palms in towards your knees, turn your fingertips pointed back towards your knees, bahar se karenge, theek hai? Rotate your hands outward, and then move your hips back, look in front, exhale, lean forward, inhale, again move back. Exhale, again lean forward. Inhale, move your hips back. Exhale, again lean forward. Keep leaning, keep leaning, keep leaning, and then exhale, move back. So now this time, just keep leaning forward as much as possible. And then hold for three, two, one. Exhale, again move your hips back. And then from here, make a circle on the axis of your center of your body with your spine, and then keep moving. One, clockwise, two, three, now anti-clockwise, pressing your both hands evenly on the floor. Three, two, and one, back to the center, turn your palms forward. Now press your hands, send your legs back with a plank. Drop your knees down, chest down, chin down on the floor. Inhale, swing yourself forward for the cobra. Exhale, roll your spine back for the mountain or downward facing dog. Now press your palms, bend your knees, jump front, half a look up. Exhale, completely bend forward. Inhale, take your hands up over the head. Exhale, again bend forward from the hip joint. Inhale, half a look up. Exhale, press your palms, jump back. Chaturanga Dandasana. Inhale, upward facing dog, Urdhvamukha Svanasana. Exhale, downward facing dog, Adhomukha Svanasana. Very nice. And then hold there for five. Pedal out your legs one by one. Four, three, two, and one. Now press your palms, bend your knees, jump front, half a look up. Exhale, completely bend forward from your hip joint. Inhale, take your hands up over the head, stretch your arms, and then hold there, interlock your fingers, turn your palms high, and you can lift your heels off the floor into Tadasana. Exhale, release your knees down, heels on the floor, and then exhale, bend forward from your hip joint. Bend forward from your hip joint. Inhale, halfway look up, spine straight. Exhale, press the palms, jump back, Chaturanga Dandasana. Inhale, upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. And then again, hold for 5 seconds. 5 breaths. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Press your palms, bend your knees, jump front, half a look up. Exhale, completely bend forward. Inhale, stretch your arms over the head. Exhale, again, bend forward from your hip joint. Inhale, halfway look up. Exhale, press your palms, again, jump back, Chaturanga. Inhale, upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. And then hold for 3, 2, and 1. Again, press your hands on the floor, jump front, half a look up. Exhale, completely bend forward from your hip joint. Inhale, stretch your both hands up over the head. And then exhale, release back into Samasthiti. So now let's talk about any posture that you want me to discuss.
In the morning, I have asked the difference between downward dog and Parvatasana, mountain pose.
Yes, mountain pose. Okay. So anyone here would like to share their point of view about downward facing dog or mountain pose? So we have already discussed it before, right, Karen? Yes.
My understanding is that mountain pose has your feet together, and and in downward facing dog, it's more of a stretch for your shoulders and a reach. So it's more the difference between more of an extreme stretch, feeling the upper back, the thoracic spine, around the chest in downward dog, whereas mountain is, you know, heels can be on the floor, it's a little bit smaller, and just kind of less intense.
Yes, so as he told you that in the downward facing dog, we have extreme stretch in our thoracic region, and right here in our upper body. But whereas in mountain, we are stable like a mountain, as mountain does not move, right? So move nahi karta ho, so it will be all the way stable from your heel to your tailbone, tailbone to your hands, it will be stable. But in the downward facing dog, if you may have seen dog dekha apne dog, so how does he do? Just he make that arch on his back, right? So we have got this puppy extended pose. Do you know that puppy extended? So puppy and dog, they both are same, right? So puppy is like a small one, dog, when the puppy grows, then it becomes dog, right? So it should be as similar like a downward facing, like it should be as similar like a puppy, okay? So in that puppy extension pose, what happens? You'll be having that arch on your back, your thoracic region would be drop down or place down on the floor. The same like in the downward facing dog, you just need to press your hands and then tuck your toes under, reach your hips high. But the position of the thoracic region would be as same as like a puppy pose. All right, so like this. But make sure what happens, what is the main problem happens when you are lowering your chest down, you start to rotate our arms inward. So just bring that awareness in your arms so that they can rotate it outward. If they are rotating outward, so this is a tendency of our body. Whenever you're moving down, your hands automatically gets together, right? They come close to your ears, and then you, like you're just, you're not, you're misaligned into this posture, all right? So make sure whenever you're lowering your chest down, you're bringing that awareness on your shoulders, rotating them outward, then it is fine. Otherwise, stay here like a mountain pose, all right? So either you can perform mountain pose or downward facing dog, but in the downward facing dog, whenever you're lowering your chest down or you want to have that stretch on your thoracic region, the moment when we lower our chest down, our hands start to rotate inward. If you have that awareness to rotate your arms outward, then it is fine to lower your chest down. Okay?
Where should be the gazing point in downward
the
dog?
The gazing point,
looking at navel point, but in mountain pose?
In mountain pose, it will be all the way like in front. Okay? It should be like all the way straight from the heel to your tailbone. So let's perform this posture so that we can understand. Everyone, please come up on your mat. Press your hands on the floor. Send your legs back for the plank. And then mountain pose. Keep your heels together, feet together. Pressing your hands. So here in the mountain pose, we won't have movement. Do not move your spine. Keep reaching your tailbone high. Look in front, or you can tuck your head in so that your ears would be in line with your hands or in line with your spine. All right. Keep reaching your tailbone high. Yes, Shivani, just reach more up high towards the ceiling. Good job. So this is your mountain pose. Whereas in the downward facing dog, you can bend your legs at the knee, bend your legs slightly, bend your legs at the knee, lift your heels off the floor, and then you will feel like that more outer rotation will start to happen in your arms. Okay. So as you are doing that, Dev Janiji, so you are just rotating your hands inward. When you're lowering your chest down, your hands start to rotate inward. All right, so that we don't need to do. So rotate your hands outward and then lower your chest down. Yes, now it's rotating inward. It's still just rotating inward. So in the downward facing dog, make sure have that shoulder impingement. Whenever they are rotating inward, you will have that shoulder impingement. Make sure your arms are rotated outward so that you can create the space in your shoulder socket. And then you lower your chest down, you reach your tailbone high, and then like your chest is going to be parallel to the floor. All right, in the downward facing dog. But it's not necessary to like get deepen into the downward facing dog. You can always bend your legs at the knee so that you can reach your tailbone higher than before. Okay? Yes, the common alignment of the downward facing dog is to rotate your hands outward. So you should also understand the placement of your palms. If your index finger are not parallel to each other, like this, if they are not parallel to each other, then if they are like turning inward, your hands will start inward rotating. If your hands are rotated outward, then it's going to be like better than rotating your arms inward. Okay. So always turn your palms outwards so that you can shift your body weight on the outer edge of your palm right here, because it's rather stronger than this part. So you can always press your palms from the outer edge of your hands, just like this, and then reach back. See, if I'm going to get down, my hands will start rotating inward. So what I have to do, You can grab your mat from the sideways and then press your hands, look in front, or you can tuck your head in. So now my hands are not rotating inward. Now this is the perfect alignment of the downward facing dog. But if they're rotating inward, it's going to be misaligned. Okay? So try to grab your mat from the corner and then try to perform this posture, this downward facing dog. Grab your mat and look in front. Lower your chest down, reach your tailbone high. Very nice. So just bring that all awareness in your arms, in your shoulder socket, how they are allowing you to get more deeper into the posture. If your hands are rotating inward, that will not allow you to get deep, to get deeper into the posture. But if they are rotating outward, it's going to be stretched more out. Okay. So if your hands are rotating inward, then you'll have the shoulder impingement. If your hands are rotated outward, you are creating space, then you won't have any problem or you won't have this shoulder impingement. Okay, so any other posture?
I just wanted to confirm our Chaturanga.
Which posture?
Chaturanga
Dandasana. Okay, so in Chaturanga Dandasana, so do you know about this outer rotation of your hands? This is the outer rotation, this is the internal rotation. This is the outer rotation and this is the internal rotation. Can you put yourself, can you mute yourself so that everyone can hear? So this is the outer rotation of your hands. When you're rotating outward, this is the internal rotation of your hands. Okay. So in Chaturanga Dandasana, what happens if you're rotating your arms outward? Outward means your elbows are moving outward, but your hands are rotating inward. So this we don't need to do in Chaturanga Dandasana. You have to always rotate your arms outward, bend your elbows, and then lower your chest down like this. Okay. So it's not necessary to get lower than your elbows, lower than your elbows, like this. Many people, they do Chaturanga Dandasana like this. So they are not holding that posture, they are just hanging into the joints. So what do we have to do it here? Do not get lower than your elbows. Lower than your elbows means your shoulders should be always above than your elbows or in line with your elbows. If they are moving below than your elbows, it means you're just hanging into the joints. Okay, so what you have to do, bend your elbows, rotate your arms outward, and then lower down. So this is fine into Chaturanga Dandasana. All right, so there are three actions is happening in this posture, the outer rotation of your arms. This is called the protraction. This is called the retraction. So everyone, please come up on your mat. So whenever you're extending your arms forward, your scapulas, your shoulder blades are getting away from each other. This is called protraction. When your scapulas are coming together, this is called retraction. All right. So what do you think when you are here in the Chaturanga Dandasana, what happens? Protraction or retraction? So this is the protraction. When your shoulder blades are away from each other, when shoulder blades are coming together, that is the retraction.
Retraction.
Okay. And what about this flexion of your arms, extension of your arms when you are bending forward?
It's flexing.
Flexing, right?
Yes.
See, let's suppose if your hands are flexing, do we have to sustain this flexion and this retraction altogether? Retraction altogether. If you're sustaining this flexion all the way down, if you're just holding this flexion, then it won't be any more Chaturanga Dandasana, right? So let's suppose my hands are bending, and then I'm just bending forward. Unless I resist this action, all right? So I have to resist these two actions, like this this flexion, and in this Chaturangandhanasana, there's a retraction, I have to protract. So what does that mean? I have to restrict all these actions in order to build the strength in our arms, in our lower back, or on our thoracic region, all right? So as same as like chair pose, if in chair pose, what happens? Do you flex your knees or extend your knees? We are actually flexing our knees in order to hold that particular posture. We are just restricting that action, right? In order to extend your knees. So the same thing here in Chaturangandhanasana, your hands are flexing, but you have to restrict that action by extending your elbows. But do not extend your elbows all the way up. Just extend your elbows a little bit higher than your elbow. Just extend your hands a little bit higher than your elbows, like this till here. If you're getting too much down, so here it is all the way flexion, but here you're restricting the action. So here it's a extension of your arms. All right. So that is how you can build the strength in your arms. Let's suppose you're doing crow pose. In crow pose, same like we are restricting that action. We are trying to extending our elbows, but our elbows are bending. Our elbows are flexing. So we are trying to restrict this action so that we can build the strength in our arms at the same time in our core too. So that is how we usually build the strength. Let's suppose you are in the plank, right? You're in the plank, you're pressing your hand, you're reaching against the gravity. So that's how you build the strength in your core. If your legs is higher, so let's suppose you are laying down on your back, you're reaching your legs up against the gravity. So you're restricting that action, right? The gravity is pulling you down. At the same time, you're going against that gravity. That's how you're building that strength of your legs, right? The same thing happens in your Chaturangandhanasana. You're restricting that action. So try understanding this thing, how you build your strength. Okay? So ye samajh mein aaya sabko? Have you all understood this thing?
Exactly. Mm-hmm. What position we should hold in Chaturangandhanasana?
Okay, so in Chaturangandhanasana, what happens? The flexion of your elbows, but you have to extend it. Okay, a bit higher than your elbows. Extend and do not let your elbows go out. Just clip your elbows in towards your rib cages. All right, and drop your shoulders down. Do not elevate your shoulder lightly. Just always keep your shoulders away from the ears. Okay, so this is the position of your Chaturangandhanasana. And one more thing happens here when you are here in the Chaturangandhanasana, you make an arch on your back, just like this. So you have to draw your tailbone in so that you'll be more engaged with your core at the same time. Okay, so let's suppose I'm doing Chaturangandhanasana here. My hands are perfect, but my hips are moving high, right? So what I have to do? Squeeze my tailbone in and then hold the position into Chaturangandhanasana so that my whole body will be all the way in line along with my spine. Okay, so everyone please come up on the mat one more time. Let's perform. So now you will feel like it's going to be more easier than previous one, which you were doing, like your shoulders were getting below your elbows, right? So no need to bend your elbows all the way down. Just try to extend them so that you can build the strength in your arms, right? And scoop your tailbone in. Do not make any arch on your back. Now inhale, upward facing dog, exhale, downward facing dog. Roll back into downward facing dog. So one more time, if you are jumping back into Chaturanga Danasana from the forward bend, come up into forward bend. Now, as you inhale, halfway look up. Exhale, press your palms, jump back into Chaturanga Danasana. Yes, bend your elbows immediately. Yes, and then hold. So this is your Chaturanga Danasana in which your shoulders are always above your elbows. And now from there, directly come up into upward facing dog. Yes. Exhale, roll back into the downward facing dog. So this is your Chaturanga Danasana. In order to make your lower back straight, what are the poses that you can try? Did you understand what did I mean here by scooping your tailbone in? Like we usually make arch on our lower back when we are holding into Chaturanga Danasana. Even in the plank too. If you're holding into plank, let's suppose I'm holding into plank, my upper body, my hands are perfect, but my lower body, it won't be stable like this. Right? So this is your plank. I'm pressing my hands on the floor, protracting my shoulders, but I'm making arch on my lower back, right? So what I have to do is scoop my tailbone in so that I'll be squeezed in from my hips and I'll be engaged there. The same like into the lower plank, forearm on the floor. Try everyone, forearm plank. Just bring that awareness on your butt. In your buttocks, are they, is your spine straight or is it making arch on your back? So if it is straight, so that is perfect. If you're making arch on your back, that means you need to bring that awareness in your lower back. Okay. Yes. Here, Shivani, you are making arch on your back. Yes, Sujitji, you are also making arch on your back. Just scoop your tailbone in. No, not reach high, but scoop your tailbone in like this. Okay, so let's bring that awareness on our hips so that we can understand this. Drawing your tailbone in, that posterior pelvic tilt or anterior pelvic tilt. Okay, just lay down on your back. Not lay down, just sit up straight into Dandasana. Keep your legs bent. Just like this. Now extend your hands forward. So this is your protraction of the shoulders. Okay, the protraction of your scapula. Just extend your arms forward. Keep extending shoulder blades away from each other and then lower your lower back down. Just lower back, huh? Do not drop your chest down. Just lower back down and then hold here. Just hold here. Did you find that space where you can hold? Just hold there, do not get all the way down and then hold. So you must be more squeezed, more engaged with your abdomen right here. And then again hold. Now lift your legs up 30 degree off the floor, 30 or 40 degree or slight up off the floor, 3 or 4 inches, and then take your hands back. Take your hands back over the head. Do not let your shoulders down, do not let your scapulas down on the floor. Yes, so this is that drawing your tailbone in. So this engagement should be there when you are here in the Chaturanga Danasana, whether you are in the plank or lower plank. All right, so we won't make any arch on our lower back. So this should be all the way straight, like here in this position. Now one more time, everyone, please come up into this position, extend both legs forward, take your hands back. Keep your legs high and then hold there for 10 seconds. 10. You can extend your arms forward too if it's getting too intense. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. From the end, swing forward and then hug your thighs. So did you understand this? just drawing your tailbone in. Okay. So now one more thing we can do in this. Yes.
I felt like all the pressure on my core and abdomen raised by holding onto that pose. Okay.
मैं समझ नहीं आया दोबारा बोलना.
I'm feeling all the stress in my core, like the abdomen region.
Yeah, this would be right there in your abdomen, because the more you engage with your abdomen, the better you will have that straight spine on your lower back, right? तो वहाँ से आपको straight spine start होता है जब आप abdomen की squeeze करते हो.
So I was supposed to do that only while doing plank.
Yeah, while doing the plank, the same thing. The engaging your abdomen, drawing your tailbone in. So drawing your tailbone in means here you have tailbone. You have to take your tailbone inward, in between your legs. All right. So one more thing we can try here. Come up on the plank. Take your legs back. Now scoop your tailbone in and then hold. One. Let your hips go higher. Squeeze and then hold. Two and one. Forearm plank. Now still your hips are in line with your shoulders. Now from here, do not take your hips higher than this. Just squeeze and then lower your hip down. All the way lower your hips down. But do not drop all the way down. Inhale, reach up, and then exhale right there. Inhale, and then exhale, squeeze your hips. Inhale, and then exhale, squeeze your hips. Inhale, and then exhale, squeeze your hips. Just keep moving just like this for 10, 9. Make sure your hips does not go higher than your shoulders. 8, yes, 6, 5, lower your hips down, and then 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Now release back. So that is how you are going to engage your core, engage your hips. All right. So one more thing we have, we can make a wave against the wall. All right, so do you know the wave, how you can make the wave out of your body? So let's everyone please come up close to the wall and like touch your head against the wall. All right, so from here, how you are going to do, drop your head, then chest, then your abdomen, then your pelvic girdle, knee down, then take your knee back, drop your head, chest, pelvic forward, and then knee down. Again, head, chest, and then. So this is for those who cannot bring the awareness on their hips. So here you can bring that awareness on your hips, all right? By doing this movement, making wave out of your body. Just drop your head first, and then chest. Take your head away from the wall. Now hip forward. Then knee forward, and then again. So one thing should be there at a time, your head, either head or chest or hip or knee, right? Now head, chest, then hip, then your knee. Just like this, just keep moving, and then speed up your wave. Just keep moving. One, two. So you are starting from your head and ending to the knee. Again, starting from your head, ending to the knee. Just keep moving, make a wave out of the body. One, two. Yes, make a wave. Yes, Sujitji, drop your head first, then chest, then hip, then your knee. Again, come back, again, drop your head, chest, then hip. See, when you're dropping your head against the wall, the moment when you drop your chest, you have to take the head away from the wall. Now, after that, your hip would be on the wall, your chest would be away. After that, your knee would be on the wall, then hip will be away from the wall. Okay? So one thing should be there at a time. Keep moving your spine. Just try understanding, make a wave, swing forward, bring that awareness, close your eyes, and then try. It's better to do with the closed eyes. Yes, Karen. Head, chest, then hip, and then your knee. Very nice. Knee. Now come back, then head. So one thing should always be there, whether your knee or your head. So when you're leaving, when you're ending this moment, when you're ending this wave from your to your knee, then drop your head against the wall, then your chest, then your hip, then your knee. Now all the way come up and relax. So anything else that you want to ask about this Chaturanga Dandasana? So this is how you can engage your butt, engage your lower back, right? So the moment when you engage your core, your lower back will automatically get straight. Right, we have natural curve. We have got natural curve on our lower back. But when you're engaging your butt, your lower back will get straight. All right. So try to bring that awareness on your abdomen so that the moment when you engage, your lower back will be straight. So that Chaturanga Dandasana you can also try against the wall, right? As Karen is doing, you can keep your hands right here. Against the wall, right? Rotate your arms outward. If your hands are rotating inward, you will feel like you cannot bend forward. When you're rotating your arms outward, you can stay here holding into this position. If still you are having that arch on your back, you have to scoop your tailbone in just like this. Press your hands, look in front. So this would be the position of your Chaturanga Dandasana against the wall. Okay, so let's try this one too. Keep your hands in line with your elbows. Keep your palms in line with your elbows. Rotate your arms outward. Depress your shoulders down. Look in front. Press your hands against the wall. And now close your eyes. And bring that awareness on your hips. Right? So here, I'm not engaged with my butts. So what I have to do is scoop my tailbone in and then I'll be more engaged. I'll be stand erect more perfectly than before. Scoop your tailbone in, look in front, press your hands, depress your shoulders down. Shoulders are away from ears and you'll be more engaged into this position now, right? The same way we are going to do this Chaturanga Dandasana on the floor. The tailbone should be tucked in, shoulder should be away from the ears, and you will find yourself into Chaturanga Dandasana. Now come back and then relax. Anything else that you want to ask about? See, when we do chair pose, so we also discussed a little bit about chair pose. So in chair pose, also like your knees are flexing, but you are trying to extend your knees so that you cannot fall over, right? So in order to extend your knee, you will have that more engagement on your thighs, at the same time on your hamstring and your glute maximus and medius, right? So here your hips, so that is going to get more strength in the chair pose. So do you know about that range? Do you know range? जिससे हम वो स्क्रू खोलते हैं, right?
It should not go beyond our tools.
What?
Our knee should not go beyond.
Yeah, see, in the chair pose, make sure your knee does not go further than your toes, right? If your knees are going further than your toes, you may have that ligament tear on your knee, right? So it should be always behind your, like behind your toes or in line with your toes. It should not go further than your toes. Okay. So as I told you, the range. So if your knee is going forward, too far forward, further than your knee, further than your toes, you cannot find the balance right here, right? So if it's in line with the center of the gravity, it's going to be quite easy to be stable and hold into this particular posture for long period of time. Let's suppose your hands are over the ear. If you're bending too much, you cannot hold here for a long period of time because the gravity is pulling you down towards the floor. If your knees are back, so now center of the gravity is here. If your knees are moving forward, now center of the gravity is pulling you down from there, right? So body itself is trying to find the center of the gravity, center of your body. That this is also another reason that you need to always find the balance in the center of the gravity when you are doing the chair pose, right? And there's a second reason why you don't need to send your knees forward further than your toes, because you may have that ligament tear. All right, so there are two reasons. First is the center of the gravity, second is that ligament tear you may have. All right. So otherwise, in the chair pose, many people, they bend forward from here, just like this. And many people, they just reach up from your thoracic and from your hip joint. So this is completely fine. You have to make a nice, like 90 degree of your body, 90 degree angle of your body. From your abdomen to your thigh, it should be 90 degree. From your lower leg to your upper leg, it should be into 90 degree, right? So that you can be more stable, you can be like alternately, you are making that 90 degree angle. Okay. So if you're moving further than your 90 degree angle, then you're going to find the balance and you'll be more uncomfortable into this posture. Any other question? And your knees should not come together, they always be away from each other. If you have knock knees, then they will automatically come together, but you have to maintain the gap between the both legs, like according to the hip distance. Yes, please perform the posture so that you can understand. Yes, so you just bend forward from your hip joint. Thoda sa bend forward ho jao. Ha, bas. Now it's perfect. So did you understand that chair pose, Chaturanga Dandasana and downward facing dog mountain pose? Any question that you want to ask about these postures?
While doing presentation, downward facing dog, then mm-hmm. we drop our knees, then chest, chin down. After that, we go to Chaturanga. So do we need to hold in that position?
Which the Ashtanga Namaskar, knees down, chest down, chin down on the floor. Who cannot perform this Chaturanga Dandasana? So there we have option that knees down, chest down, chin down on the floor, that you can also try.
So So in that case, when we drop our knee, chest, and chin, mm-hmm. so in that case, our hips will be up.
Yes.
And yeah, chest will be down, and head will yes. be up, right? So
yes,
we need
yes.
to hold in that position, then we need to go in upward facing dog, right?
Not upward facing dog. Yeah, you can get into upward facing dog or into the cobra pose. So basically from the knee chest in down, we swing forward into cobra. So that is made in such a way.
Okay, so yeah, that's the difference of Hatha and Ashtanga.
Yes, yes, yes. That's the difference between Hatha Yoga and Ashtanga Vinyasa. Okay, then let's finish our class. Sit up straight on your mat. Hands on your knees. Close your eyes. We will chant one Om followed by three Shanti. Inhale. Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. Join your hands together in front of your heart center. Bend your head forward. Open your eyes while blinking, and namaste to everyone. Thank you so much for joining me here. Enjoy your evening. Bye-bye.
Thank you, Raul. I'll see you Saturday. I have to miss okay. tomorrow and Friday.
Okay, bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Bye.